get going. And as we go through with the next videos, we'll just iterate on the same T script. So we'll begin by creating on start block. We'll leave this empty. And then on stop block. Oops. We'll leave that one empty as well. So we're going to initialize the first two channels of this device. We're going to start by setting the bitrate. So can set bitrate. First channel we're going to set to can, oops, bit rate 500k. And the second channel will do the same. So now that we've set the bit rate for both channels, we'll turn them on by using can bus on function. All right, so when this device boots up, it will set both channels to 500K. And we'll turn both channels on. Now when we stop, we want to make sure to shut both channels off as well so we don't get errors. So let's do that. All right, so now when the device powers down, it'll shut down both channels and we won't get any errors. So ultimately what we want this to do is receive a CAN message with any ID on channel 1 and then write that same message to CAN channel 2. And same thing with channel 2. When we get a message of any ID, we want to take that message and write it on channel 1. So let's create a hook, an on CAN message hook. All right, and in between the greater than and less than symbols is going to be the channel that we want to target. So this channel, can ID any, so asterisk says, hey, whatever can message we have, we get any ID, then we want to invoke this function block here. So when we receive a CAN message with any ID on CAN channel 1, we want to CAN write to channel 1, channel 2, I'm sorry, this message. And this is the message that we receive. You can see that this is a what's called a structure. We'll get into this a little bit later. So we put dot ID, that would be the ID of the message. We're gonna use this here in a printf statement. So printf is gonna help us out with determining whether or not we hit this block. So let's go ahead and just write a simple printf message in here. It says, we received a can message with ID of hex. All right, so this is an escape sequence. When we use the percentage sign, we can insert a variable, or we can say, hey, this dot ID we want to see right here. Now the X says that we want this variable to be printed as a hexadecimal character. And we would use percentage D for decimal. We'll do that here in just a second. So we received a CAN message with ID of hex, this.id on channel. This dot channel plus one to put it into human readable context anyway, saying that we received it on CAN channel one. So let's do the same thing. I'm just going to copy and paste. We'll do the same thing. When we receive any message on CAN channel 1 or CAN channel 2, so when we receive any CAN message on CAN channel 2, we want to write it to CAN channel 1. And there's our first T script. So let's go ahead and save this script. And we'll compile it. Now, when you compile it, you'll see that we have an unsaved project, so it will force us to create a new project when we compile it. So we'll go ahead and save this project. And we have an error. Let's see, what did we do wrong? Line 14, unexpected colon, expecting a semicolon. There we go. So I made a mistake. The compiler tells me where the issue is. I can go in, fix it, recompile, and we're good.